Good day to all of you. Computer Shiksha is supported by. In today's class, you will learn something new. But let us first revise what you had learned in the previous class. Can you tell why we use COUNTIF and COUNTIFS formula? If from a given data, you want to get the count from a row or column based on one condition, then you will use the COUNTIF formula. When you want to get the count from the given data's any row or column based on two or more than two conditions, then you will need to use the COUNTIFS formula. Can you tell what is the difference between SUMIF and SUMIFS? Using the SUMIF formula, you can get the sum or total from your data for any name and based on one condition. However, if you want to get the sum from your data based on two or more than two conditions, then you will need to use SUMIFS formula. Can you tell why we use the arrange option? Using the arrange option, you can arrange your objects in different orders. For example, you can set your object as the background of a cell and even above the cell. Can you tell why is the average if formula used and what is the syntax for this formula? Using the average if formula, you can get the average from your data based on any one specific data value. The formula you will use for this is equal to average if bracket begin range semicolon criteria semicolon average range close the bracket. Do you know what you can do with the comments option? Using the comments option on your spreadsheet, you can give a comment for any cell. This comment will be shown in the spreadsheet page margin. Now, all of you switch on your computer and open your spreadsheet file. Let us now get to know what you will learn about today. You will be learning about the remaining options of the tools Meno, like spelling, detective, goal seek, solver, scenario, share document, merge document, protect document, and cell contents. And then you will also learn about some formulas also, like text, left, right, mid, find, search, substitute, length, trim. Type the data being shown to you in your spreadsheet document. Now, go to the second sheet and mistype some words in any of the cells. Can you tell how you will correct the spelling of the misspelt words on your spreadsheet? For this, you will use the spelling option. Let us watch the video and understand how we can correct the spellings of the wrongly spelt words on the spreadsheet. Let us watch this video and see how we can use the spelling option to correct our wrong spellings on the Calci sheet. So for that, we first choose one of these sheets, sheet 2, or let's choose sheet 1 itself. And on this sheet, let's type some word which is spelt wrongly. So, just as an example, we are typing the word computer, but notice that the spelling is wrong. So, when you press enter, you will see that a curved red line appears under this word because the spelling is wrong. Go to tools, go to the spelling option, click on that, and you can see that the wrongly spelled spelling is shown in red, and also some suggestions are given. So choose the correct spelling, click on change, and then click on yes. Then you can close the spelling option. So you will see that the spelling option makes your wrongly spelled word into the correct spelling. The next option is of detective. If you have applied a formula in any of your cells, then the use of the detective will show you by a line where you have used the formula. Within detective, there are many options which you can use for various tasks, like trace precedence, remove precedence, trace dependence, auto refresh, etc. Let us watch the video and see how these options are used. Let us watch this video and see how we use the various options of the detective option. So there is some data already on our CALCI sheet, some numbers and probably some formulas have been applied. Go to the tools menu, click there, click on detective. Now there are various options here: trace precedence, remove precedence, trace dependence. So if you click on trace precedence, it shows you from where the formula has been applied, and this arrow indication is given. If you want to remove this, you will go back to tools, go to detective and remove precedence, select remove precedence. However, since this was not selected, you need to first select it. So we select this as we had done earlier, go to tools, go to detective, and now click on remove precedence. So that arrow mark has been removed. Once again, let's select this, these numbers, go back to tools menu. If you want to use the other options, click on detective, and now there are other options that we are going to see. Click on detective once again, and you can see there are remove all traces, trace error. So if you click on trace error, it shows you where the formula, wrong formula had been applied. So here in the formula bar, you can see that we had applied the SUMIF formula, but it was wrong. So it gets highlighted. Once again, we go to tools menu, go to detective, and then go to mark the error. So here this error is shown, and as you can see, it gets highlighted that this is where the error is. Go back to tools, go to detective, and if you click on fill mode, your cursor changes to something like what we use in Paint. So it's a different type of cursor for fill mode. Once again, going back to tools menu, going to detective, and if we click now on refresh traces, choosing tools again, go to detective, and if you remove all traces, then all the traces, all the markings will not be shown again. Still your cursor is in the fill mode, so if you want to remove that, go to tools, go to detective, and unselect the fill mode. Your cursor will become normal again. So this is how you can use the various options of detective to find out where the formulas are used and where the error is possibly. Can you tell why we use the goal seek option? Using the goal seek option, you can get the desired value in your cell and can also change the value. Note that this option will work only on formulas. For example, if the marks of three subjects are 50, 70, and 75, the total of which is 195, now you want that the total marks should be 200. Then you will use goal seek, which will change one of the subject marks such that the total becomes 200. However, for this, you will need to define the value cell and target value by yourself. Let us watch the video and see how the goal seek option is used. Let us now watch this video and understand how we use the goal seek option of the tools menu. So for that, what goal seek will do is that if you have some numbers, some data, and then you have totaled them, found the sum, but you want that the sum should be a certain target value, then you will use goal seek so that you can change some of the variables or some of the numbers that you have already got in your data and then make the sum equal to the target value. So on sheet 2, as you can see in the video, we have data from 3 teams A, B, C. They have performed round 1, round 2 and round 3, and some marks or some data is given. You can see that the total for this is 597. However, for we want that the total score or the target score should be 660. However, in C team, in the third round, marks are not given or data is not there. So now we want that the total should be equal to the target value. We select the total cell. And then we will use the goal seek here. The C3 data, something so that the total should become the target value. So we go to tools, go to goal seek. Then we have already selected the formula cell, which is our total value, which is 597. Then we have to type in the target value. The target value is 660. So we will type in the target value, and after that we have to select the variable cell which we want to change so that the total value becomes the target value. So in this case, we want to give some data for C3, 6F cell, 6th row F cell. So we click on OK, and then it says the goal seek is successful. Do you want to insert this result, 63? So we click on yes, and you can see that for team C, the third round now has the score or data of 63, and this makes the total equal to 660, which is also the same as our target score, which was 660. So this is how we will use the goal seek to modify our data such that the sum that we are finding becomes equal to a target value. Can you tell why is the solver option used? Using the solver option, you can change the range value with a target cell value. Here, you can give more than one cell range. Let us watch the video and see how the solver option is used. Let us now watch this video and see how we use the solver option. The solver option is also very much like the goal seek option, but here you can make changes on more than one variable. So here we can see that we already have some data. Let's use sheet 3 data. So here we have an objective, which is the target value of 49. And we have variables B1, B2, B3. For all of these three, the value is given, 15, 30 and 4. Now, when you total this, the value is 49. However, we want that this target value should be something different, and we should be able to change any of the variable values. So, let's define our target value. So we can write that the target value that we want this sum to become is 100. So we write here target value 100, just for our reference. Then we select this cell where the objective or the total sum value is given. Now we will use the solver. And the solver will help us to change one of the variable values or more than one of the variable values. So we go to tools, click on that and click on solver. The box opens. The target cell is already defined, which is our total value. Now optimize result to, you can have three options: to maximize, minimize, or you give a value of. So if we use maximum, just to show you how it will work, and we select by changing cell, we select B1, the cell where 15 is written, click on solve, and it shows that if you want to maximize, the result for this cell or the total will be 34. So now you can either keep the result or you can restore to previous position so that you can try out various options. This time let's look for minimum. So we click on minimum. The target cell is already defined. Once again, by changing the variable cell B1, the where 15 is, and we click on solve. Again, you will notice that it shows you that the solving, the result is 34. If you don't want to keep it, go back to previous values. Now let's look for our target value, which is 100. So in this case, we will choose optimize result to value of. So we will select that value of option here in this, and we write the value that we desire, the target value. So our target value is 100. We write it here. And by changing a cell, which variable cells you want to change? So we can select one or more than one. Right now we are just selecting one, just like in GoalSeek, and click on solve. So what it does, it says the target value has become 100. Do you want to keep it? So we say yes. So you see the B1 variable value has been changed to 66, so that our objective value is the same as the target of 100. Supposing we want the target to be 200. In that case, once again, we will select the objective value, which is the total value. Go to tools, go to solver option, and from this table, the target cell is already selected. Value of now becomes 200 because our target is 200. And let's say we want to make this change by changing two of the variable cells. So we have selected B1 and B2 both and click on solve. So once you click on solve, this operation is finished successfully. When we say we want to keep the results, you can see what it has done is it has changed both B1 and B2. B1 has become 196, B2 has become 0, such that the total is 200. This is how you use the solver. What do we use the scenario option for? After typing a value for a row or column, you need to again give it a value. Then you will use the scenario option. Then, if you want to see what was the value originally and what is the current value, you will need to make use of the scenario option. You can define this by name and can also use the navigator also for this. Let us watch the video and see how the scenario option is used. Let us now watch this video and see how we can use the scenario option. So let's first copy some data from one of these sheets to the other sheet so that we can apply a scenario on them. So from sheet 2, we are just copy pasting this team ABC, only this much. We copy this by selecting it and then using the shortcut Control C. And on sheet 3, we just paste it by using Control V shortcut or by using edit command. Now we have this. If we want to apply a scenario on this, we will select this data which we have just copied and pasted. Then go to Tools menu as is being shown in the video and select the scenario option. Once you click on that, a box opens and you can give a name for the scenario. So we can erase what is written here and give our own name. For instance, we are giving the name CS. And already you can see display border, copy back and prevent changes option has been selected. So all these options will get applied on the scenario when we click on OK. So border will be displayed and you can see when we click on OK, the border has been applied. And also there is a drop down arrow, which if you click on the drop down arrow, you can see the name of the scenario being shown to you, which is CS. Now we have selected this data already, which is there, and we apply a second scenario. Go back to Tools, select Scenario. Once again, it gives you the option to change the name. So we erase what is written here and let's call this scenario CS1. So we type that CS1. Again, display border is there, prevent changes is there. Click on OK. And now if we delete this data which was there, and instead of this data, we type some numbers. As you can see in the video, we are typing 6, 8, 8, and then 6 or 4. Now, when we click on this, when you click on the CS scenario, you can see team ABC written. When you click on CS1, you will see the numbers 6, 8, 8, and 4 appearing. So this way you can apply different scenarios on your data, on your Calci sheet. Can you tell why we use the share documents option? Using the share document option, you can share your spreadsheet data with someone else. But for this, your system must be connected to the server. Let us look at this video and see how this option is used. Let us watch this video now and see how we can use the share document option to share our spreadsheet sheets with other users who are also connected to our server. For this, our system should be connected to the server. To do this, you have to take your cursor to the Tools Mino. Click on Share Document, a box opens and there is an option saying share the spreadsheet with other users. Click on that to select it, click on OK, and it says the spreadsheet must be saved now to activate sharing mode. And do you want to continue? If you say yes, this gets saved. You can see in the title bar now, this document has become a shared document. So now other users who are connected to the same server where your computer is connected can use this spreadsheet document also. However, if you want to not share it or unshare it again, go back to Tools Menu, click on Share Document and unselect what you had selected earlier. Share this spreadsheet with other users, unselect that by clicking on it and then click on OK. So you get a message which you will see in this video. Disabling shared mode of a spreadsheet hinders all other users of the shared spreadsheet to merge back their work. Do you want to continue? Yes. So once again it gets saved in the normal mode and is not any longer a shared document. So now users who are on the same server will not be able to share this. Next is the option for protect document. With the protect document, you can apply a password on your spreadsheet document with which your sheets become secure. Using this, you can apply a password to your entire document or on your sheet. Watch the video to see how protect document option is used. Let us watch this video now and see how we can protect our document or sheet using the protect document option of the tools menu. Take your cursor to the tools menu and click on protect document option. Once you click on the protect document option, there are two options here, whether you want to protect the sheet, this particular sheet, or the entire document. Right now we just want to protect the sheet. So we select sheet, a box opens which says protect this sheet and the contents of the locked cells. Now you can give a password to protect this. Now your sheet is protected. So any user who has access to this sheet cannot make any changes. If you try to enter something or delete something, it gives you a message saying that these are protected cells and they cannot be modified. So this way your sheet is now secure. You can use the same protect document option to protect the entire document also. If you want to unprotect it, go back to tools menu, go to protect document, click on sheet again, and now you can give the same password which you have typed. Now your sheet is once again unprotected, which means that you can make any changes on this sheet. You can type something in it, like we have typed 12, we have typed 21, and we can also delete from this sheet. So you can use this as a normal sheet. This is how you will use the protect document option to protect or unprotect your sheet or document. Can you tell why we use the merge document option? Using merge document, you can merge your current spreadsheet data with some other data. Watch the video and see how the merge document option is used. This video will help us understand how we use the merge document option to merge our existing data with another document which we already probably have. So to use this, we take our pointer to the tools menu and click on merge document. As soon as you click on merge document, a box opens which is the location of your other document. So you can select that, click on open, and another box opens which shows accept or reject changes. So there is a list here, you can accept or reject any of these changes. If you go into the filter tab, you can use the date, author, and you can set a start time or a date and time. You can also select a range from your document which you want to accept or reject the changes in that area. And you can also give an author and also give a comment if you like. So like in the comment we are typing ABC, then if you close this, this is how you can use the merge document to merge your existing data with some work that you are doing. Now, since you have already learned about the gallery and media player, go ahead and show how you will use these options. If you face a problem, watch the video and learn from it. Let us watch this video now and just practice how we use the gallery option to insert a picture object from the gallery, and also how we can use multimedia player. So we go to the tools menu, click on gallery, and you can see the gallery option is available to you. There are many themes to choose from. Like you can click on schools and universities, text shapes, symbols. There are many more. You can scroll up and down. There is transport, finance, my theme, or some home pages. So if we want to choose one of these, click on that, right click on it, choose insert and copy, and it gets copied on your spreadsheet. So you can see that it is already there on your spreadsheet now, and according to your need you can change it, drag it, or resize it also. So this is how you can insert any object from the gallery option. Now, if you want to use the media player, you will again take your pointer to the tools menu and click on the media player option. Now, the media player option is available to you, and the bottom left icon is for open. So, when you click there, various locations on your computer are open, and you can choose your multimedia, which could be a picture or a audio or a video file, and click on open. Since right now we don't want it, we are just closing this. But this is how you can use the gallery option and the media player. Now, all of you will learn about some new formulas like text, left, right, mid, find, search, substitute, length, and trim. Let us now learn about the left formula. With the left formula, you can define how many characters you want to show or see from the left side. The syntax for using this is equal to left, begin bracket, put the text in inverted commas, semicolon, and put the number in and close the bracket. Watch this video to see how this left formula is used. Let us watch this video now and see how we can use the left formula to see or show characters from the left side of the cell. So, if we want to show two or three or a number of characters from the left side, beginning from the left side, that is what we can do by using the left formula. So, to use this, let's first go to sheet 1, where we have a lot of data like name, surname, and email IDs. So, in the D1 cell, let's type left, or rather let's type first name, because if we want to show the first name from the email ID, the title we'll use is first name, and then we will use the left formula for doing this. So we type equal to left, and it shows you the syntax left, then begin the bracket and select the text from where you want to find this first name. So we select this email ID cell, put a semicolon, and then give a number till where you want to show the characters. So since Pankaj is of 6 characters, the name Pankaj is of 6 characters, we will type 6 here and close the bracket. And once you enter, press enter, you will see it shows you the first name Pankaj. However, if you notice in the other names, the characters could be 6, or they could be less, or they could be more. And this formula will not work properly if we just drag it downwards, because it will just show the 6 characters, first 6 characters from the left side, and not really the first name. So if we want to do that, let's try a different method of doing it. So we will use the left formula again. So let's just type the title as left. This time we will use the left formula, and we will also make use of the find formula. So we use equal to left, and then we will select this email ID from where we are trying to find the first name characters. So we use equal to left, begin bracket, and then select the text, which is the email ID. So we select the C2 cell, put a semicolon. Now, instead of the number, we are going to use the find formula to find out the number till where there is a dot after the first name. So once we find that, that will tell the left formula the number, So we will say find begin bracket, and then in inverted commas we will choose the text, which is the email ID. So again the seat, sorry, we will use the dot because we want to find till the dot. So we use find begin bracket, within inverted commas we put a dot, put a semicolon, and from where we are finding is the C2, which is the email ID. Then we close the bracket and we do a minus 1 because we don't want to include the dot. So we do a minus 1 and close the bracket to complete the left formula. Now when you press enter, it will look for the first name and show you till 1 before the dot. So now you can see Pankaj is being shown. Now if you drag this downwards, use the same formula for the other email IDs, see what happens. In whichever name there is a dot, the correct answer will be shown, the first name will be shown. However, if there is no dot in the email ID, then till there is a dot, like the second dot is there in Deepika Kaidav at gmail.com. So till that dot it is going to show. So it shows Deepika Kaidav at gmail. Similarly, Kalpana Kumari at Yahoo and Sonia Kaur at Hotmail. So let us try and see if we can use some other way of doing this. Supposing we want to find the characters from the left side till the at the rate symbol. Now this is very clear. We want all the characters to be shown till at the rate symbol. So we will again use the left and the find formula, but this time in find we will use at the rate symbol. So we say equal to left, begin the bracket, choose the text, which is the email ID C2, semicolon, and for number we will use the find formula to find where the at the rate symbol is, and we will do a minus 1 as you had done earlier for the dot. So find begin bracket and within inverted commas, what is it that you are finding is the at the rate symbol. So you put at the rate symbol within inverted commas, then put a semicolon again and select the text, which is the email ID itself. So C2 cell after the semicolon, close the bracket, C2 cell first, as is being shown in this video to you, close the bracket, and then minus 1, and then close the bracket again so that the left formula is completed. And then when you press enter, you will see that Pankaj.Sharma, the text Pankaj.Sharma appears, because that is the text which appears before at the rate symbol. Now if you drag this downwards, the same formula, or if you double click on the black dot in the right bottom corner, you will get for all the email IDs till at the rate symbol, whatever text is there will be shown to you. Let us now learn about how the write formula is used. You can define the number of characters you want to see or show from the right side by using the write formula. The syntax for the write formula is equal to write, begin the bracket, put the text in inverted commas, semicolon, and then put the number and close the bracket. Let us watch the video and see how the write formula is used. Let us now watch this video and see how we will use the write formula to find out the rightmost characters that we want to show or see on our Calci sheet. So for this, we are typing last name. So we are just calling the characters like com or in as the last name. This is what we want to see or show. So for doing this, we will be using the write formula. So we'll say equal to write. The write formula is equal to write, begin the bracket, as has been shown in the video to you, and then select the text, which is the email ID itself. So C2, cell C2 we select, then semicolon, and the number. So if we want 3 characters to be shown from the right side, it is easy. We will just put a semicolon and put 3 as the number that we want to see or show, and then close the bracket. And when you press enter, you will get COM, which is the last name. We are calling it last name. So the last 3 characters will be shown in this cell. However, if you drag this down and apply this to all the others, you will see that you also get a dot in, because here IN was only 2 characters. Therefore, it is showing you dot in. And in one more case where dot CIOM was there, only IOM is being shown. So let's see if we can do this in a different way. We can use write, and we will use the find formula along with it. So here what we will do, we will first use the write formula equal to write, begin the bracket, select the cell from where you want to find characters from the right. So that's the email ID. So cell C2, put semicolon. Now we want a number. So first let's calculate the length of the email ID itself. So for that we will use the length formula. So after semicolon, we will say LEN, begin the bracket, and then select the email ID. So it will give you the length of this email ID, close the bracket, and then minus, we want to now find where the dot is. So we say find, minus find, begin the bracket, and within inverted commas, we will put the dot, because we want to find the dot. So within inverted commas, you put a dot here, semicolon, and then the text, which is the email ID itself. So once again, C2, cell we select, put a semicolon. Now we want to find one more time the @ symbol, because we want to only find the last characters after the dot. So we are now saying find with begin bracket. Within inverted commas, we put the @ symbol, put a semicolon, and the text is again the email ID, so C2, and then you can close the bracket, but now you have to close the bracket for the first find and the write formula also. So close the bracket 3 times and then press enter, and you can see COM is returned to you, or COM is shown. So if you look at the formula, which is in the formula bar up here, you can see write, then we select the cell, then we calculate the length, and we are finding the dot first. So we are minusing or subtracting from the length where the dot is, and we are also finding the @ symbol. So after the @ and the dot, whatever is left we are showing. Now when you drag it down, you can see that the correct last name, com, and CIOM and in, are now given back to you. So this is how you can use the write formula along with the find and length formulas if you want to get the last name. Let us now see how the mid formula is used. You use the mid formula when you want to define the number of characters from the mid of any text that you want to see or show. The syntax for the use of this mid formula is equal to mid begin bracket text in inverted commas semicolon start in inverted commas semicolon number in inverted commas and close the bracket. Let us now watch the video and see how the mid formula is used. Let us now watch this video and see how we can use the MID formula to find characters from any text, the middle characters from any text. We can define how many characters we want. So let's type the title MID and then apply the MID formula. There is a MID formula for doing this. So we use that equal to MID. And then if we want to do it from one email ID, it's easy for us. We can count the characters. So we first type equal to MID, begin the bracket, select the text. The text is the email ID. So we are selecting the email ID, which is the C2 cell, semicolon, and start from where. So we want to start from the @ symbol. So we count these characters, Pankaj.Sharma. These are 14 characters. So we type start 14. So C2 semicolon 14 semicolon, and how many numbers you want. So let's say you want 4 from after the @ symbol. Close the bracket, press enter, and you can see it shows @ and GMA. This is happening because the @ symbol should have been 15. So instead of 14, we can correct that by going to the formula bar and typing 15 instead of 14. Once again, if you press enter, you will see that the whole of Gmail is not appearing, only GMAI is appearing, because Gmail is 5 characters and we had said 4 characters. So once again, let's click on that, go to the formula bar and correct this also. So we can correct it to 5. Now press enter and you can see Gmail will appear. However, if you now drag this formula down for getting the MID value for all the other emails, you will see different characters will appear, because in Pankaj Sharma we started count from the 15th character, but in the other email IDs the 15th character might be something else. So we'll have to use a different formula or a different method using the MID formula to get the MID value. We want to get characters like after @, things like @gmail is appearing. So we want only Gmail to come, or Yahoo, or whatever else is there, like Hotmail. So once again, we use the MID formula equal to MID, select the text C2, semicolon, and now for the start number, we are going to use the find formula. So we type find, begin the bracket, and from what do we want to find? We want to find the @ symbol. So put the @ symbol within inverted commas, put a semicolon, select the text, which is C2, because that's the email ID, close the bracket, and then +1, because we want after @ symbol. Now we want from @ symbol till the dot. So we'll have to use find once again. Find after the semicolon. Find and then open bracket. And this time we want to find the dot. So the dot in inverted commas, semicolon, select the text, which is the email ID or C2 cell. As you can see here, after the semicolon, we put the C2 cell, select the email ID. This is a mistake, we don't want find right now. This is a slightly difficult concept. So if you want, you can make a note of this, so that when you use it again, it's easy for you. So we selected the cell C2. Now notice that there are 2 dots in each of these email IDs, or in most of the email IDs. So we will have to take care of that. So we will have to use find more times. So after C2, after selecting the cell, we will have to use find again. And this time we will use find for at the rate symbol. So find begin bracket. So we are having a find formula within the find formula. So remember, now we are using two brackets. At the end we will use two brackets. Find inverted commas within inverted commas at the rate symbol. Then the semicolon, and from where we want to find is the email ID C2. And now the double close brackets and minus. What do we want to minus? We have to find the other dot, if there is another dot. So we'll say another at the rate symbol. So we will have to say find begin bracket within inverted commas at the rate symbol semicolon, then the text itself, which is C2, close the bracket, minus 1, because we want to find whatever is written between at the rate and the dot. So we want that mid value. So if you press enter, you can see Gmail appears clearly. So this is a slightly difficult concept, but you will understand once you practice it 2-3 times. So we're using the mid formula, as you can see in the formula bar. Mid, then select the text, which is C2. Find the at the rate symbol. Add one, because we want after at the rate symbol. Then again find the dot, because we want to go till the dot. And within that, find select C2, because that's the text. We want to find once again the at the rate symbol within the same text, which is C2, and minus find at the rate within C2 cell minus 1. So this is how you will get the correct mid value or the mid text that you want to show after the at the rate symbol and before the second dot, which is appearing in this particular email ID. So in some email IDs there may be only one dot, but by using this formula, the correct value of the mid text will appear. So now if you drag this formula down for all the other email IDs, you will see that it gives you the correct answer for all the other email IDs also. You can drag it down, or you can double click on the dot, and you can see it shows Gmail, Gmail, Gmail. In one case, we have wrongly spelled GHmail, so that is shown Yahoo, Hotmail. So this is how you will use the mid formula. Do practice this 2-3 times so that you can understand this clearly. The next option is for search. With the use of search, you can search for any word in your text and get to know the position where it appears in the form of number. This is not case sensitive, meaning you can type the word you want to search in either capitals or small letters. The syntax for search is equal to search begin bracket, put find text in inverted commas, semicolon, and then put the position in inverted commas and close the bracket. Watch the video and see how the search option is used. Let us watch this video now and see how we find the position of any text by using the search formula. So for this, we will type the search formula, which is equal to search begin the bracket and then the text that we want, which will be in inverted commas. So if you want to find where Gmail appears, which position Gmail appears, we write Gmail in inverted commas, semicolon, and then select the text from where we want to find out, which is the email address and the position, the first position for Gmail. And when we hit enter, or when we press enter, you can see it shows 15. So Gmail appears in the 15th position of this. Now this is not case sensitive, which means that you can type the letters that you are looking for either in small or capitals or in a mix. So right now in the formula bar, you can see we erased Gmail in small letters and typed it in capital letters and pressed enter. It will still show that Gmail appears in the 15th position. So this is not case sensitive. However, if you use find, when we had used find and we had written Gmail in small, it had found the position. But if we write Gmail now in capital with the find formula, it will give you an error because find formula is case sensitive. So whatever text you are trying to find should be in the same capital or small letters as it appears in the given text. So this is how you can use the search formula and the find formula. Find is case sensitive, search is not case sensitive. Can you tell why is the substitute formula used? Using the substitute formula, you can replace your existing text with some other text. The syntax for this is equal to substitute begin bracket text in inverted commas semicolon search text in inverted commas semicolon new text in inverted commas semicolon and occurrence and then close the bracket. Watch the video to see how the substitute text formula is used. Let us now watch this video and see how we will use the substitute formula. So with substitute, if we have some word or text which we want to change, we will use the substitute formula. For instance, you can see in Sanju Sharma, sanju.sharma121@gmail.com, the Gmail spelling is wrongly typed. So we will substitute that with the correct spelling. So we type equal to substitute, begin the bracket, then select the text, which is the Sanju Sharma email. So we will select that text or that cell as is being shown in the video. So we select the C7 cell, which has that email ID, then put a semicolon and then in inverted commas, type the text that you want to substitute or replace. So since the text which is typed there wrongly is GH mail, we type that within inverted commas, then put a semicolon again and type the correct word against this, which is Gmail. So Gmail again in inverted commas. Put a semicolon and the occurrence, it is happening only once. So we put the occurrence as 1, close the bracket and press enter. And you will see that the correct spelling has now been given here. sanju.sharma121@gmail.com. Let us see this one more time with some other email ID. So for instance, there is avinash.thakur@gmail.com, but the com word has been wrongly spelled. So we can use substitute here. So we type is equal to substitute, begin the bracket, and then select the cell where you want to substitute or replace some text. So you can choose the same C5 where Avinash Thakur is there, or let us do deepikayadav@gmail.com, because you can see we have not typed a dot between the first name and the last name, surname. So let's choose that C4 column where deepikayadav@gmail.com is written, and then put a semicolon and within inverted commas type Deepika Yadav as it appears in the email ID. There is no dot in between. Then put a semicolon and type the correct way that you want it to appear, which is Deepika and then dot and Yadav. This also you have to type in inverted commas. Then a semicolon and then the occurrence, it is happening only once. So you will type 1 as the occurrence and close the bracket and press enter and you will see that it appears now in the correct format, deepika.yadav@gmail.com. So this is how you can use the substitute formula to make any wrongly spelled text, you can change that or substitute that with the correct text. Can you tell why is the trim formula used? If your text has more than one space in your data, then you will use the trim formula to remove the extra spaces. Watch in the video the usage of this formula. So watch this video now and see how we use the trim formula to trim out any extra spaces that are there in any text. For instance, when we are typing computer here, notice that we are giving 2-3 extra spaces. Now, let's first count the number of characters by counting the length of this particular text that we have just written. So, we use the length formula for this, equal to len, begin the bracket and then choose the cell where we had typed computer with spaces. Close the bracket and press enter and you will see that instead of 8 characters which form the computer word, here it is showing 11, which means that there are some extra spaces, 3 extra spaces here. Now let's use the trim formula. So we will use the trim formula here in this cell, equal to trim, T-R-I-M, then begin the bracket and choose the text that you want to trim. This text where computer with spaces was typed, press enter and you get the word computer. Now let's find out the length of the second word computer which has been trimmed. So again we use the length formula, equal to len, begin the bracket and now choose the second word which has been trimmed, close the bracket and press enter and you can see now it shows only 8 characters. So this is how you can trim any extra spaces on any text on your Calci sheet using the trim formula. Since this class now ends here, all of you save your file and then after closing it, shut down your computers properly. Today, you learnt about the remaining options of the tools Meenoo, like spelling, detective, goal seek, solver, scenario, share document, merge document, protect document, and cell contents. You also learned about some formulas like text, left, right, mid, find, search, substitute, length, and trim. Computer Shiksha is supported by Thank you.